Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time Master Quest. I am Midnightsun.
Hi, I'm Lightspectra again.
Yes, he's back. And today we are going to be doing the Water Temple with drinking.
Ooh, Water Temple drinking game.
Water Temple drinking game. Alright, so first of all, I guess we should go over the rules for this drinking game.
Okay.
Alright.
One, every time you change the water level in the temple, take a shot.
Yeah, and two, you're going to understand this once we're actually in there, but there are these wall symbols. You'll see them, like these little thingamajigs on the wall. And every time that I activate one of those up to a certain point, because who knows, we might just be too smashed to stop anyway. But every time I activate one of those, we are going to take another shot. It's kind of the gimmick, that like the Master Quest gimmick of the dungeon.
Well, you got the big Goron sword.
I do have the big Goron sword. There's a collection video for that, and it should be up at the same time as this, so...
Nice.
If some of you haven't watched that yet, then you should go watch it. Or if I haven't put it up yet, then I'm a laziest. I'm a lazy dickhole, so...
I'm glad Link got the big Goron... Harvey got the big Goron sword, because, you know, we all have small dicks anyway. Okay, so that's a running joke we have now, so...
Okay,
I won't explain it, but it's
funny.
Everybody has small dicks. That's all you have to know about that.
It's really funny, okay? Alright, so, Water Temple. Kind of annoying in terms of the very beginning, because I think that's actually where you have to take those iron boots off and put them back on the most, like the very beginning.
So, does Link just carry the iron boots with him?
Yeah, he does.
So, why doesn't it just carry it, weigh it down?
Because it's in this magical place called the inventory.
Oh. We enlarge our sacks in order to...
larger sacks. Anyways.
Okay, so what are we doing first?
First, we're taking off the boots, and we're going to have a rendezvous. Rendezvous? What is it? Rendezvous?
You don't pronounce the last, five syllables in every French word.
Yes, you do.
So it's rond. That's the word.
Alright, we're meeting up with Princess Ruto here.
Dude, full frontal nudity.
Actually, in the 3DS version, they made it look a lot more... By the way, right now, Harvey would have a surprised look on his face.
He's floating.
He's just so damn concentrated on getting up.
He's a terrible man.
He is a terrible man. Actually, you see how she has those fins back there?
Yeah.
In the 3DS version, they make it look a lot more like it's actually clothing.
Oh.
Like they have little things like peeking above her boobies.
Yeah.
Her booby prizes.
So we saw her naked when she was a kid, and now she's all grown up. So
yeah.
We've officially been promoted from pedophiles into just normal perverts.
Exactly. You know, we were kids back then. It was totally chill. You know, you show me yours, I'll show you mine. Oh, wait, you don't have one? What's that? Oh my goodness, boys and girls are different!
So the evil monster in the temple.
Yes, there's an evil monster. Stop getting us back on track.
I'm sorry.
Okay, yeah, but there's an evil monster in the temple and we need to follow her.
That's why the water level is so low in the lake?
Yes.
Okay.
What?
You know, the lake, it's all dried up?
Yes.
Because of the monster?
Yes.
That is amorphous, so it would want water?
Also,
it makes sense.
I think I may have just, okay, whatever. But yeah, so... Harvey's just chilling out, taking a look at us. We're floating up. We're gonna have to go into that room. Usually, you would have to blow up that wall, but they're nice enough to show you it.
So the water temple was a hazard for everyone who played Ocarina of Time as a kid, because it's freaking huge, and also there's so many things to do that it's hard to figure out where to get started unless you use a strategy guide like Scrub. Yeah. But
admittedly, I did use a strategy guide on this because I thought we were gonna be recording this very night, so I didn't do my usual one or two playthroughs of a dungeon first.
Thanks for admitting that you're a scrub.
But actually, funny thing about getting this temple done. First of all, fuck this room. Second of all, three Stalfos. Fortunately, with the big Goron sword, if we get a jump attack in, it only takes two hits to take these guys down.
Yeah.
So that's part of the reason why I decided to bust it out. I considered putting it away in the very opening of the dungeon, but then I remembered, wait, Stalfos.
You're not even getting hit. This is quite easy, actually.
Yeah, usually I would be a little bit more worried, because, you know, I've had less hearts in the past, and I had to worry about getting all those hits in, that kind of thing, but...
Yeah.
This lets me just kind of get through the combat scenes a little bit more easily, also. Wait, here comes... Okay, take a shot.
Okay.
Take a shot.
So every time that happens, take a shot.
Yep.
Alright.
By the way, this episode is, sponsored by VAT19.com. VAT19.com, purveyors of curiously awesome somethings.
Drinking things that are made out of gummy sugar crap.
Yes, we're drinking out of gummy shot glasses. They're really awesome. Keep talking while I pour.
Okay, so Harvey's going back into the other room, and there's the symbol that you need to play Zelda's Lullaby for, because it's the Triforce.
Yes.
And, yeah.
Oh, here we go. This is gonna rack up pretty fast, bro. I'm not gonna lie.
Water level.
Admittedly, okay. Svedga is kind of nasty to me, so.
Yeah.
It got like a 92. It got like a 92 out of 100, but I think it may have been for like Cheap Vodka Magazine. No, should I pour a little bit too much
water? I'm the editor for Cheap Vodka Magazine, actually.
You ass. Anyways.
Okay. Maybe they'll feature us in the next issue if we're like, yo, so we made this video where we drink your crappy liquor.
Yeah. Fortunately, the gummy shot glass makes it a little bit more. Oh my god, this room's so dangerous. You see that thing there? It's dead. Like, one thing.
Oh.
Yeah. Never forget this gimmick, by the way.
Are we taking a shot
wait,
now?
Wait. Oh, shoot. Did you see that sick move, bro? I got both the Liz Fos in one spin attack, bro.
That was pretty cool. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, okay.
Take a shot?
Wait for it.
What's that?
I'm sorry. I just wanted to show what Navi says. Oh, yep. Take a shot. It's only 20 rupees. Didn't actually do anything, but you want to know what? For now? We want to get good and stinky, so. Anyways.
Compass,
blah.
Man, the compass is so worthless.
The compass, yeah. Like, actually, in the Water Temple, when I was a little kid, this is how bad I was. Get this. I would always miss the key that was in the very bottom. Like, in the center pillar. So I always thought that I had done something wrong, that I had gone out of order, and it was just screwing me
actually,
over.
Actually, a lot of people thought that. Like, if you went to GameFAQs in, like, 2002 or whatever, there was a lot of threads that's like, did I permanently mess up the Water Temple? Oh, yeah. Take a shot.
God, we're just all over this shit.
It's like 5 minutes into it, and we've taken, like, 4 shots already.
Yeah, but I actually restarted the game 3 times my first run-through. Because my first run through, I thought, oh, you know, I had the strategy guide, but at this point, like after beating the fire temple with almost no help from the guide, I felt so boss. I was like, who needs to actually use the freaking guide, right?
Yeah.
So 3 times I restarted my game. I played through the entire game up to this point 3 times before I realized there's a room down there.
So I want to do a Freudian psychoanalysis of this temple because we get a long shot from it and we use it to extend our. What?
We also have to fight the id.
The id, yeah.
We'll see that in a few minutes, though. Don't get too excited, people. All you psychoanalysts out there, analyzing Winnie the Pooh. That was the most horrible thing I've ever seen in a textbook, by the way.
Psychoanalysis of Winnie the Pooh?
Yeah, take a shot.
Okay. Ooh. Okay, so we
God,
have...
it tastes so good!
No, it doesn't. Okay, so
it
we have
does
the...
taste
we
good, the gummy shot glass.
We have the big Goron sword
from
and the long shot.
I'm hoping that
and we're hunting through this temple to find a naked fish woman.
Yes.
Who wants to marry us.
Actually, I always thought it was kind of weird. She went into a dead end, and she didn't come out.
Yeah.
By the way...
NPCs can hack. That's how it rolls.
Yeah, I know. Like, do you remember StarCraft 1?
Yes.
The NPC always knew what you were doing.
Not only that, but, you know, like, first mission of the Brood War, it's like, oh, I noticed you had, like, 5 Sea Shanks. I'll just roll up with, like, 10.
Yeah.
And I'm good at StarCraft, okay? It wasn't me sucking. It was
just better than me. Anyway, but yeah, this, what was it again? This stupid guide. I was talking about the guide. Yeah.
Who cares at this
whatever.
Point?
Whatever. Okay. Yeah, but the guide,
I think we're tipsy enough
that.
At this point that we don't have to be coherent anymore,
maybe
but let's try to be.
Maybe you are.
We took, like, 6 shots, man. Come on.
Oh, come on. Listen, we've taken those 6 shots fast. It's gonna take a few minutes. Anyway, going through the dungeon. Yeah. A few things are different. Like, that thing down there, usually there would have been a recess for one of those eye things that you would shoot. And then this area here is a little bit weird. There's a, as you can hear, there's a Skulltula to get, a gold Skulltula. Well, you can't hear, but they can.
Okay.
Also, this is one thing you're gonna notice. Now, I promised to not use any fairies, and ever since the, oh yeah, by the way, get ready. Here we go.
Take a shot.
Yeah. Ever since that thing in the, forest temple, I haven't used any Lon Lon milk, but this temple is really bad. It punishes you so much. If you're not getting any fairies, because there are almost no hearts to be had.
Yeah.
So it's like, if you take damage, screw you.
Yeah. You can always, Oh yeah, you said the milk thing.
Of course, Nintendo doesn't... No, but like, it just... Also, that bottle went somewhere.
Yeah.
And I was I tried hitting that wall, I thought, wait, is there like a destructible wall here that I just don't know about?
No, it clipped through the graphics.
Yeah, I know, but...
Like, it just happened again, like a second ago. You could, like, see the outside of the wall.
Yeah, I know, like, I'm used to that happening, but I'm not used to objects flying through the walls. That's different, and that could have been I already am at full hearts, I wouldn't need that heart, but...
Yeah.
Near the end of the dungeon, as you'll see, I was treasuring every heart that I had.
Okay.
Like, I decided... Yeah, you'll see. Anyway, another switch and a timer that is basically useless because we don't need to really care about the timing when we have almost infinite time to get at it.
Right.
Oh yeah, we're about to change the water level again, so...
Four more.
To you, sir.
Okay. So the goal of this dungeon is you're basically trying to get into the various rooms and making the water level exact.
Yeah.
Like, you know that elementary school problem where it's like, this holds 5 ounces and the other one holds 3 ounces. How do you get 4 ounces out of that?
Yeah.
Like, that's basically the sample in a nutshell. It teaches kids math, but without numbers. So it's really useful educational tool.
Yeah. I mean, also, one thing that's different about this that's actually very different is that you couldn't get into that center room.
Oh, wait, take a shot. We changed the water level.
I already took the shot.
Oh, sorry.
Because I was going to let you speak, so. Anyway, yeah, that time switch is not going to be important. It would have been, but you'll see what happens later on for those of you who watch the entire damn thing. Anyway, this room would usually not be openable when the water was there. Because of the fact that, you know, we needed the, you used to have to ignite a torch in order to get back into that center room.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, and by the way, this is why I put the, block of time there before to do this. We're gonna need dense fire for this. There are just torches everywhere in this room.
I feel like Master's Quest, like, demands a lot from the gamer. Like, you had to know to put that there, or would you just figure that out after, like, half an hour of frustration?
Originally, half an hour of frustration. Really, there are tiny clues that it will give you, or maybe it kind of just relies on you being, you noticing everything around you.
Yeah.
I mean, this was made back in the day when Nintendo Hard was already being kind of, you know...
Yeah.
Was already kind of going out.
I beat Ocarina of Time. I mean, I used the strategy guide for, like, the Water Temple, but other than
you
that...
dick.
Oh, come on, I was, like... What do you call that when before you were a teenager?
Preteen?
Preteen, yeah.
Or tween?
Don't call it that. Nobody tween. Called it, in my day, nobody called it that, so screw you.
I'm older than you, aren't I?
Yeah. You're like a year older than me.
Yeah.
So now the viewers know the ages of... Well, the relative ages.
Yeah. So now we can do one of those math problems. You know, Lightspectra is younger than Midnightsun by 1 year, but Sarah is older than Midnightsun by 2 years.
No, Rudo.
Oh, yeah, Rudo. Oh, God. Anyway, this room screwed me up so much. Get this. Okay, so there's that thing there, and it's like, okay, whatever. I'm rolling into things, and that's awesome. Lol, right? Okay. So it's like, I hit that switch, and it does absolutely nothing. It's just a trap. It only produces one of those dudes, but that does absolutely nothing. There's nothing up there to get. If you do not just kind of wander around, like, I'm just going to inspect this. If you do not just kind of wander around this room, you will never get this, but look. Look, like, even I, like, for a second there was like, what? What? And then I remembered just how much of a dick Nintendo was.
You know, it's starting to dawn on me that if kids had, like, some kind of phobia of water, like swimming or whatever, this temple would be the worst thing in the universe.
It sinks.
That was definitely not obvious.
It wasn't.
Like, but anyway, what if you had, like, a fear of, like, water, and the temple makes you, like, okay, you have a fear of fire, right? But you don't have to, like, walk through fire in the fire temple. Yeah. In the water temple, you have to, like, watch the air bubbles escape you and know that you're not going to drown.
One thing that you can't really tell maybe too much by watching this video might just think that I'm horrible controlling the game. Shot. But underwater is really hard to turn. Like, you make really wide turns underwater.
Yeah.
So it's not as horrible as some games because you don't need to go underwater as much. But when
small
you're there...
Key. So we have big Goron sword, long shot, and small key.
We finally got the small key.
It's okay because everybody has small dicks. So for the viewers...
That's two strikes, mister.
For the viewers out there, I just like to say that we've drank half the bottle of vodka already.
Well, actually, I drank a little bit of that beforehand.
Well, it's half gone.
Well... We're gonna finish the rest of it.
All right.
Listen, I've done like one of these things in a night, so don't you dare puss out on me.
I'm not.
Okay. Good.
I just want the viewers to know.
You just want the viewers to know?
Yeah.
Aren't you nice? Anyway, wow, I'm really gonna have to boost the audio on that because I am probably not getting through it all. Anyway.
No, you are.
I am. You're such a nice person. Okay. No. 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 We're not going there.
Alcohol brings out the weirdest side of you.
Hey, Lightspectra, how's it going, bro? Jeez, I've had a few drinks, and you're starting to look a little bit less beardy. Beard! Anyway, there's another inside joke. But yeah. So, once again, we exit this door through the awesomeness of being able to go through sliding doors underwater. If that was like a handle door, we could not go through handle doors underwater. But slide doors, you can basically go through... As long as you're in front of it.
I think the unique part of this dungeon is the fact that everything is in the center, and you're just getting from top to bottom. Like, in the fire temple, it was linear. It's like, you're trying to go, like, from room to room. But in this, everything you want to do is in the middle room, and everything else is around, or whatever. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I do. I mean, it definitely brings back the idea of a nexus.
Yeah.
Like, in the Forest Temple, we definitely had one of those. In the Fire Temple, it was kind of less there.
So can we Chrono Boost small keys out?
No, we cannot Chrono Boost small keys. Actually, there are very few small keys to be had.
In Master's Quest?
Yeah.
In Ocarina of Time, there's at least, like, four, I remember.
Yeah. In here, you don't need as many. By the way, yeah, once again, Nintendo being a complete dick. It's only once you finally gave up and decided to turn back and hookshot away that you would have noticed that. But I am going to be really horrible at this. Well, it's less like I was going to be horrible, more like I knew what you had to do, but I decided not to, just because these are some of the assumptions that people would probably make. First of all, let's go ahead and hookshot onto the closest one, right? The lowest one, and make our way up? No.
And then
wrong.
You died.
Very wrong. Also, you have to reactivate that switch every single time you come back into the room. I really should have fast-forwarded this.
No, I like watching you fail. It gives us more time to reflect upon the meaning of life.
What is the meaning of life?
Water Temple drinking game?
God, you're right. Alright, so once we're finally in focus, because this is taking a long time, like I'm moving my Overlord across the map. Eventually, I'm going to scout my opponent.
We're always with the StarCraft references.
Well, that's because that's like our main activity together, StarCraft. And you always own me, but you know what? I don't care.
It's okay.
It's fun to lose to you sometimes. Anyway, so this is a bit more of the right idea. Okay, maybe if I hookshot onto one that's a little bit higher. And then I'll hookshot up to the one that's the highest, right? You know, that sounds pretty good, you know?
No.
Wrong. Very wrong.
And then Harvey died.
Harvey is a dreadful person. He died. He deserved to die. Do you even realize what he did?
So not only did he make Princess Ruto wait 7 years or whatever, but then he died in her temple.
Not even, like, Princess Ruto. Also, you know, there was Milan. You know, Milan, I finally got tired of waiting, and I took out my bow here. You know, there's Milan. Milan was probably like, oh my gosh, I remember that one kid, Harvey. He was so cool.
He was so nice to my horse.
Yeah. And then, you know, it was all like, oh, hey, I'm Harvey. And it's been, like, 7 years. And she's like, where have you been? This douchebag Ingo has been all over this farm.
Yeah,
he's
Harvey,
been staring
Harvey
at
is
me.
A heartbreaker. What's
he
his deal?
Heartbreaker. Sometimes
also Saria and Zelda and
oh god Saria
the Big Goron, like he has so many mistresses that he just never goes back to.
The Big Goron is not a mistress,
dude. He gets an iron check for him. You know that means they're gonna be banging by the end of the night,
dude. It's a gigantic dude.
So what?
I finally decided to get smart here, and I remembered something very clear from my childhood.
What?
I remember that I'm a freaking idiot. Also,
that's clear from your childhood that
also,
you're a freaking idiot?
Yes, I remember that I'm an idiot, because remember the switches? By the way, that was a switch.
Take a shot.
Finally. Gosh, it's been so long. I finally remembered, hey, wait a minute, maybe if I hit those switches, something will happen. Oh, by the way, this is an awesome room. Now, you don't have sound, but they do, so I'm going to explain what's going on. First of all, I thought that maybe I had to use the song of, you know, the Scarecrow song, Get Across the Room.
You have really high EPM for Scarecrow song. That song was played in like 2 seconds.
Yeah, it's basically a superfluous song, so I was like, you know what, just get it done as fast as possible.
I remember when I was a kid, I was playing on my brother's save file, and I made the Scarecrow song like something really complicated,
oh,
and
God.
He hated me every day of my life since then, because he couldn't figure out what
baby,
it was.
Baby, what's that sound, baby?
No, like, he even looked it up in the menu, but it was still like... It was like left up down 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 left up down. It was like something.
You douchebag.
Yeah.
I thought maybe if I played the Song of Storms, because Navi was like rushing over to that center platform, and sometimes that means if you play the Sun Song or the Song of Storms, something would happen. But no, three Stalfos, all three of them jump attack me. Fortunately, only one can actually hit.
You lost so many hearts.
I only lost two that time actually, because only one of them can actually hit. But Jesus, it's a Stalfos, bro. And fortunately, I just kind of need to just keep on, like, you know, stabbing him.
Harvey loves thrusting with his big Goron sword.
Stop. Okay, and here I kind of lost track of which Stalfos I was targeting. But finally, we got back to it. He only needs to take one more hit. Come on. Yes!
Nice. That was like a samurai thing where, like, they both strike at each other and then the other one falls over because he was the only one who was actually hit.
Yeah. Like in every single
samurai
show
every
samurai
movie.
Possible.
Yep.
Alright, however, we finally get down.
Dude, this gummy cup looks... No, sorry, it's... What is that scent you use with your nose? It smells so good, I want to eat it right now.
Wow, you are really, really,
No,
really
I'm not. Don't say that.
Yeah, I'm a drunk one. Yeah, so a little bit of confusion. Finally got up. Now we just need to get in the right angle. You know what? Even though I wasn't drinking when I did this, for some reason, I started to progressively feel more and more like I was losing my senses as if I had been drinking.
It's because you anticipated that we were going to do the drinking game.
It could be. Like, I was actually pretty excited that day. I was like, oh my goodness, we're going to do the drinking game. It's going to be awesome.
Spikes. More phallic symbols. Sigmund Freud strikes again.
Also, are those dragons... Like, everybody always says that they're dragons. I always thought they were, like... They look Hydra like heads.
Serpents, yeah.
So, like, yeah, they would be serpents, and I didn't want to hit that other...
Can they evolve into lurkers?
That's a Hydralisk, bro.
Oh, sorry. Oh, I love... This is my favorite part of the symbol.
Okay, by the way, check out my shadow. Check out my shadow. Check it out. Check it out. Check it out. I didn't notice it until, like, this time, but... Oh!
What?
It's gone, bro. It's gone. Dude, my reflection in the water.
Dude, Dark Link is, like, the coolest mini-boss ever. Because you actually have to figure out what to do.
Not too hard.
But, I mean, if you use a strategy guide, like you did.
Well, no, actually, Dark Link, I was a little bit, like, even though it said use the Megaton Hammer, by the way.
I like how Navi said conquer yourself. Master of your own domain, yeah.
Yes. So basically, this is what's pretty sweet. Check this out. If you swing sideways, or is it thrust? I forget which one it is, but like one of them, yeah, if you thrust, he'll actually stand on your blade, bro. But yeah, basically you need to use not the Master Sword to beat this guy.
You have to use a weapon that he does not have, so the hammer or the Bigoron Sword.
Or actually Din's Fire, like, if you time it right, it can be effective.
That's a waste, though.
Yeah, I guess. You know, I mean, eventually, yeah, you will run out of magic, and then you'll kind of be bummed. Even though you don't really need to use all that much magic power in this dungeon, like... And I usually like to use my magic power, but I can't really.
I like how you're trying all the different things out, like use the bow, use the Bomba Shoes. You have that?
I actually do have the bomb chews, yes. Unfortunately, the bomb chews are just about as useful as you'd think they'd be.
So, like, instant kill?
No, fucking useless.
Well, that's what I think, how useful they are.
Okay, I stood right next to it, my back flipped out. I was so sweet. I was like, dude, my timing, what? But still, no. And by the way, bomb chew?
Oh, you did try it. I love you.
Just go straight past him. God, that was useless.
Get him against the wall and then try it again.
Okay, Megaton Hammer is definitely the cheapest way to do it, but even the Bigoron Sword will still block.
Yeah.
But eventually, you stab him. Like, if you just do the straight stab, he can't block that shit.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take a shot for fun.
Okay, sure.
Yeah,
beat the
dungeon's mini... By the way, you can't hear this man. The mini-boss music is still playing. Like, if you could hear it right now, bro. The mini-boss music would still be playing. I was like, oh my goodness, I'm in such danger right now.
Fairy.
And actually...
Why didn't you get the fairy?
Because no fairies. Remember? No fairies
Sigmund
allowed.
Freud strikes again.
Yes. Oh, and by the way...
Take a shot.
Wow, we just took a shot. This is good. This is a good dungeon. I like this dungeon. Bro. You're embarrassing me, bro.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. He's only 16.
I'm 21. No, seriously.
But you were 22.
I'm 21.
Anyway, more vodka? Oh, God. It's spilling over. Okay, now you know that I'm starting to get a little bit drunk when I'm wasting vodka. I hate
it's shitty vodka. Who cares if you waste it?
It's 12 bucks, bro. I don't have many more of those 12 bucks.
Okay. Fair enough. Alright, so Harvey's at half health. He's sliding down a hill. What else is new?
One thing that can actually be really annoying in this is that the hook shot, or the long shot at this point, doesn't actually come up. Like, it doesn't actually become active.
It doesn't come up.
Shut the fuck up. It doesn't actually, like, become active for a couple of seconds after you do that, by the way.
Gold Skulltula.
Yeah, Gold Skulltula. There's a couple more Gold Skulltulas in here. We're actually, one thing. I'm going to just go ahead and say this in advance. We have basically progressed to the point where we can go to the boss room. Like, there's going to be something lying directly on our path. It's the last thing you need. And I think anybody who's played the game before will know what I'm talking about. But
the map?
No. I've already got the map.
Oh.
See, I got the map right
there. I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Jeez. I thought you were smarter than that. You always talk so smart.
I'm sorry.
Anyway, but we can basically go to the boss room at this point. Like, after I fail at swing away from Vortex. Yeah.
Harvey went into the hole.
Yeah, keep the iron boots on at all times.
Do we have to take a shot for that?
No, it didn't activate anything.
Okay.
Although I wish we could. But the rules are the rules.
Okay.
Yeah, but keep the iron boots on at all times, because if you fall off, it's a lot better that you do have them on than you don't have them on. Than if you don't have them on. Just keep the iron boots on.
Okay.
Good. Okay, so running. See, like right there, I wanted to long shot so much sooner, but like you need to stop moving for a second and a half before it actually activates.
Yeah.
Anyway, this little room here is actually really annoying because in the regular game you don't have all of these hookshot targets ready for you, right? You know, it's like, oh, look at that. I need to actually walk across and behind and, like, on the very edge of all of these traps, and then you finally make it.
I have a question.
What?
Do you think Harvey's a Platonist or an Aristotelian? He seems very virtuous. On the other hand, he seems more like an ideal than a real being.
Somehow, yeah, I get the feeling that he actually is an Aristotelian. Like, okay. I get the feeling that he is the heroic soul. He has courage. He has the soul of...
Well, Plato likes courage.
Fuck Plato.
What would... Okay.
What are you, some kind of Platonist? No, you're not. I know you're an Aquilinian. I know you are. You can't get away from me, bro. I know you're an Aquilinian.
Aquilinian?
Aquinas.
Oh, that's called Thomism, bro. I wrote the Wikipedia article on that.
Did you really?
I did.
I want to go and edit it.
No, don't. I had to revert so many trolls for that article. Just don't.
Lol forms. Lol.
Come on, don't.
No. But here's the thing. I'm going to, like, right in the middle of his five arguments, I'm going to write, and then Thomas spawns Colossi and wins against Zerglings.
Okay, let's get back on track.
Okay. So yeah, basically, long shot is awesome. Long shot gets me through this. Just like Jesus. okay. Yeah, so I was really glad I had the Megaton Hammer out because I could just... Wait, did I really... Oh, really? Did I really waste the time? I did! I wasted... Okay, good, I did.
You heard it here.
I was about to say.
You heard it here first, folks. Midnightsun sucks at Zelda.
Shut up, I don't. I'm awesome at Zelda. I'm a bro.
Take a shot!
See, I told you this would be awesome.
Dude, why did you fill it, like, way over the top? It's, like, all over the top.
I told you I spilled it. Just take the freaking shot. Okay, look.
I took the shot, okay.
Dude, you...
No, I didn't. Okay, I'm sorry. I'll try again.
He didn't do the entire thing. Mommy!
Okay, there you go.
Dude, there's still some in there, bro.
Shut the hell up?
No! Oh, God. See, look, there's more for you. It's all the way up to the top again.
Okay. Like the water temple.
Just like the water temple. Actually, it currently is all the way up to the top. Okay. Anyway, yeah, so while we were just talking and dicking around, I needed to take out my Din's fire because...
Nah, dicking around.
More torches. There are torches everywhere in this game, actually, I found out. Like, they didn't really utilize torches enough in the old game, I think.
it's like they're remaking Zelda. It's like, what do bitches want more of? Torches! Okay, we got this.
I gave my torches to that bitch. Bitches love torches. Oh god, the wave file on that thing looks so hilarious right now.
I know.
Anyway,
it's loud.
Yeah, actually, funny story. My microphone jack on my desktop computer isn't working, so we're currently recording on my netbook, and just to make sure that Audacity doesn't crash, which it has a tendency to do, we currently have Audacity and WavePad running at the same time recording. So we have this on lockdown.
We do.
Plus, this is like a 50-minute video.
I like how Harvey breaks things by rolling into them.
Yeah.
It's like...
I think it's part of the reason.
Harvey, what do you want to grow up to be? And give me a backup occupation in case that fails. And he's like, hero of the land and, like, cement driver.
Hero of insert noun here.
Yeah.
Like, hero of time, hero of seasons, hero of ages, hero of winds, hero of
windfish.
Waking. Yeah, hero of windfish. God. Oh, yeah. This is one thing also. Like, you'll notice that... Like, you can see the torches. I have my hand on the screen right now. It's awesome. You can see the torches in there, but, like, you can barely see them. So I thought, oh, you know, I'll spin attack. Spinning attacking is awesome, and it usually gets me stuff.
Okay.
Of course, I should have remembered that, you know, Zelda dungeons like to repeat things over and over and over and over again. And there's been a lot of torches to light. So I shouldn't have expected just another...
How can he pound fire from the ground by... What? Is he the airbender? Like, Avatar?
No. He has Din's fire. He has a magical, like, diamond-shaped 3D object.
Is Din a firebender?
Yes.
Okay.
Din is the one that crafted the land.
Da-da. Okay.
I'm glad we decided to stop that at the same time.
Okay, yeah.
Do you remember those Austin Power movies with the Doctor? Yeah. By the way, right now, I could go into the boss room. By the way, this is the point, I'm going to do this again, just like in the Fire Temple. This is the point where those people who don't care about collection can go ahead and skip forward to, like, the,
We'll give the minute mark in the description of the video.
Yeah, actually, because the timestamps on YouTube tend to be different from the timestamps on Corel
Video
Studio. The timestamps
on your mom appear to be different.
Shut the fuck up. Because the timestamps on YouTube are, like, different, and people have commented on YouTube saying that, you know, it's different, even though, like, in my video editing software, it was on time, maybe. But because of the fact that people have noted that, I'm going to go ahead and put that as a YouTube thingamajig. So if you turned off your comments, guess what? Right about now, you should be able to see it there. I did it in the recording so that I'll remember when I'm actually putting it up on YouTube.
What is this?
This is a collection at this point.
Okay, what are we collecting?
Gold Skulltulus.
Why?
Because we want to see the rest of the dungeon. There are some pretty cool puzzles. Also, dude, fine. When you see one of the next rooms, like, you're going to flip out, okay?
Is this room?
No, you're going to like this, trust me. Actually, there's one thing that we can't do right now. There is one skull tile we are not going to be able to get, but we're going to leave
how,
too.
How would you know that that would have been there if you didn't have a strategy guide?
Like I told you, I had a strategy guide.
Well, like, how are you supposed to know?
Shut up. That's how.
I think Nintendo just hates us.
Nintendo does hate. Listen,
it's
Nintendo
like,
hated.
If you want to beat the game, it's not that bad. But if you want to get everything, you're going to be miserable, and your wife is going to leave you.
Listen, I played this game the first time, like Master Quest. I played this game the first time without any strategy guide. Okay, that was pretty difficult. That was actually pretty difficult. What the fuck? Oh yeah, that's right. The game. Remember, the game always gives you what you need.
Right.
So if you get magic power in a room, especially in Master Quest, this is especially true in Master Quest, if you get magic power and you get arrows in a room, you can bet that you're gonna have to use some combination of arrows and magic power, whether it be magic-powered arrows, or dense fire, and then firing through torches, you're gonna have to hit you with arrows, and then you're gonna have to use fire, whatever, it's giving you a gigantic clue. It's the way that Nintendo was like, okay, we understand that we made a slightly harder game than usual, so we're going to go ahead and give them a clue. By the way, I missed one torch!
Wow, that's frustrating.
It is frustrating. And then I decided to try and light it, like, right there. I was like, oh, maybe I'll hit it. Go,
no,
go, go, go!
No,
oh, and
no.
By the time I was down there, I realized...
Wow, you suck at this game.
No, I don't. I just had bad placement. And I was getting tired. Shut up. How is that even a reference to... You know what?
To the id?
To the id, yes. The id is already dead. Listen, Harvey has conquered his id.
Oh, he conquered him.
Take a shot.
Okay, fine.
Okay.
Can I just eat this cup now? It's like
no, we're gonna
no,
eat
I,
it. At the,
I
no,
eat,
we're.
Please leave it. You have more cups. Let me eat it.
No, we're going to eat at the end. When it tastes plenty like vodka.
Okay, when we beat the boss, yeah, who I think is called more. Morphelia or something.
Morphelia.
Yeah.
I have this thing for morphing. Like, I really like morphing. Like, if somebody like, when I saw, like, GoBots and they transformed, like, they morphed, I was like, oh. And the more, dude, the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers,
okay,
don't even get
I'm gonna
started.
Lean here.
Wait,
I don't mean to be gay,
look,
but I need to
look,
lean.
Okay. Look. Listen, I remember
lizards.
The last time that I saw you drunk, okay?
Okay?
I understand this is not homosexual at all.
I don't get drunk. What is this? I'm completely tipsy right now. I'm not drunk.
You're funny. Okay,
bombs.
But yeah, look at all these Dodongos, bro. Like,
why are they,
thought...
like they're refugees from the Dodongos cavern, and now they've come here because you... Are you just exterminating, like, this, like, race of people?
Yes,
I am. Is Link just, like, genocidal?
Listen, we killed the King Dodongo, alright? The Queen Dodongo now
Do you think Link
has...
is, like, Andrew Jackson is my favorite president because he's genocidal?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, wow, I'm starting to not be able to feel my teeth.
Sorry, Harvey.
Oh, wait. By the way, if you didn't know that about Dodongos, when their mouths are open, just like King Dodongo, if you throw a bomb into them...
That sounds like a useful hint.
It is a useful hint.
Okay.
Listen, part of
no,
the fact...
No, bomb! Okay, I thought it was by your feet. I'm sorry.
Part of the reason why we make LPs is to give people instructions on the video. So, yeah, Dodongos, just like King Dodongo, actually, if you had figured that out in the,
You keep throwing the bombs at your feet.
I know,
you
I
think
can't
Harvey
really
is
see
genocidal and suicidal?
Like, honestly, at this point, I realized something. I realized I have a gigantic fucking sword. I was like, you know what? Screw this, I'm gonna take out two Dodongos in one.
That's really good
hit.
Life advice, it's just like... I just realized I have a big sword.
Yeah, but we all have small dicks anyway.
Yeah.
So. Okay. Yeah, it's funnier now that we're tipsy.
It is.
Why are dick jokes funny now that we're tipsy? This is going somewhere bad. also, please tell me I got that magic power. Please tell me.
No.
No.
Midnight Sun is the worst Zelda player ever.
Oh, God, I forgot to get the... You know what? We're not even going to talk about this. This is now forbidden information. You are not allowed to talk about this.
Your mom is forbidden information.
Yes, my mom is forbidden information because if people found out about my mom, they'd know who I am.
Don't they already know who you are?
No, because my mom is actually somebody you can find out about on the internet. Oh god, people are going to take that horribly. Oh god, what did I do? I've set myself up for every single joke that I ever got in high school. About that topic. God, your laugh has gotten bad. You are getting tipsy.
Shut up.
Dude, seriously, handle your alcohol better. Anyway, I made a stupid mistake here. I should not have rolled against all of those boxes. Boxer, what?
Boxer is my favorite StarCraft player, except for Goody, because he only has like 80 APM. But that's beside the point. We're talking about Zelda.
Dude, that's how much APM I have.
Wait,
I'm actually
are we
trying...
playing Zelda or Metroid? I can't remember.
Metroid.
Okay, so when do we get the ice shot?
I forget. It's been a while since I played Metroid.
This doesn't look like Metroid.
I know.
Are you fooling me?
No!
Are you fooling my
I'm not
leg?
Taking advantage of your drunkenness. Here, have okay. more. Here, have this Rupee Colada. Dude, your laugh has gotten extremely drunk. I remember you. Okay, anyway.
Okay.
I forgot a place, so now we're gonna go to that place.
Okay.
That magical place where there's a Stalfos. Spoiler alert, there's a Stalfos.
Bro.
Then again, those of you who are already here are actually into the collection, or into us getting drunk,
okay.
or both. In which case,
they're into us.
Shut up. So anyway, yeah, I missed a room. I did indeed miss a room. I'm sorry. It's my fault. I'm a bad person. Blah blah blah. Actually, something you'll notice: there are a lot less random enemies in this dungeon. Like, there are almost none.
Kinda. You're right.
Like right here, there would have been a little crab dude.
You're rubbing the screen so erotically. You know I'm straight, right?
I do know you're straight, so am I.
Why are you doing that?
Because
the screen wants you?
Actually, I need to tell you something.
Wait, is the screen the id?
The screen came out of my closet to me the other night. And oh my god, Stalfos. Okay.
Wow, you suck at this game.
Three hearts. I'm gonna give all of you a little tip. Not really a tip, but a thing. By the way,
shot.
I remember we said we were going to limit how many shots we took. How many shots have we taken at this point?
We're almost done with the bottle right now.
We're almost done with the bottle. We're going to need to finish this bottle, dude. This bottle is basically...
Dude,
God, fucking fairy. By the way, every time a fairy is in the room at this point, like, because of the fact that even though they fly away from you, they, like, go in circles, so at some point they are heading towards you. So I always feel like I'm in a time trial with the fairies. Like, I got to get out, by the way, that freaking
Small
key. How are you supposed to figure out that key was there?
Because you open pots?
That key will actually be featured in a future video. Right now, we are not going to use it because at this point, I got, like, so tired. Like, this video... Like, I thought the fire temple was long. At least the fire temple was interesting. It varied things up. But unfortunately...
This temple is all the same thing. It's just, like, hitting switches, killing Stalfos.
It's like, water. The fire temple at least looked exciting. The water temple is just kind of like...
That's because fire is, like, dangerous. It's like,
yeah.
Okay, fire is, like, the Fonz.
Yeah.
And then water is, like, the guy from that show that nobody else remembers.
Oh, God, you're right. I can't remember that show.
Happy Days. Yeah, lovely. People who burp are communists, except me.
This is the best video ever. You know what we should do?
What?
We should definitely, like, ask Tipping 40s if we can do an LP with them, because they
what
drink...
What is Tipping 40s?
They're an LPing group that drinks a lot while they LP.
Well, we're beating them right now.
Actually...
You know what? You can shut up.
Actually, some of them have taken, they've gotten, like, it's kind of funny. They do their videos in, like, segments. They put segments up in, like, you know, like, day after day after day. They have, like, an LP video every single day. They're awesome.
Yeah. Okay.
By the way, what did I
it.
Do this for?
You're a good judge of character. I believe you.
Right. At this point, actually, I'm pretty much done with collecting. I was just kind of going
around.
Should we
just go kill the boss or something?
Wondering what I was going to do. I actually think I did something here that I'm going to regret in a few seconds.
Did you use Din's fire underwater?
No, I think I changed the water level.
You know what that means?
You can't use Din's fire underwater. The only item you can actually use underwater. Stop moving. The only item you can actually use underwater is the long shot / hook shot. But we already have.
I can
long
use
shot,
my long shot underwater, for all you ladies out there.
There are actually videos like that. By the way, we're about to change the water level. You know what that means?
Wait,
here we go.
Wait, is this the shot right now?
Yes, right
okay,
now.
Okay, take it.
Take it.
You just spilled it all over your crotch.
Now my dick is drunk. Okay, so.
Okay, so. We got this.
All right, now I'm actually starting to feel a little bit tipsy, too. I'm definitely in the tipsy camp. All right. So, basically, at this point, I was done. I was like, you know what? Fuck this. Like, the guide was being a little bit unhelpful. I was using
pour.
This...
You gotta pour the drinks.
Okay, jeez. I'm fucking done already, so that's like,
oh, we're about to change the water level or
oh,
something?
Oh, wait, you're right. We are about to change the water level because we need to get into the boss room, which means we need to get into the top floor.
I'm always right. That's all you need to know about me. Except when I'm wrong.
But yeah, except when you're wrong.
That's not what I'm counting right now.
Like when you play Zerg.
I'm good at Zerg, man.
Yeah, you actually are. You beat me with Zerg at this point.
And he's a Zerg player.
Dude,
so
listen,
really
I didn't rush you. Like, I would have tried to, like, do some early pressure with you, but you sound like you were so angry with early pressure. So I was like,
no,
you know what?
When I'm Protoss and they six pool me, and I'll usually
wait,
win.
Protoss six pool?
No, when they're Protoss and they six pool me.
No, you just said, yeah, exactly. Protoss six pool. There's no such thing as a Protoss six pool.
Fuck you. I can There's... six. Bitch, I can six pool all I want.
Wait, we just changed the water level.
Oh, take a shot.
Oh, God. Stop that.
I'm sorry.
You're embarrassing me. Okay, but, okay, anyway.
I'm still here. Okay.
You're still barely. Listen, at least you're not being over-analytical about things. Like, I remember the last time that I saw you drunk, you were really over-analytical about things.
Dude, who would win in a fight?
Yeah, but at this point, when I change the water level again, take a shot.
I'm shotting. I'm shotting.
Wow, we were really almost done with that bottle. That's amazing. But yeah, at this point, at the point when I raised water to the second level, I finally just said, you know what? I'm fucking angry with this dungeon. I do not want to
be in
this.
Okay, a shiver just went up my spine. Like, a shiver.
That means you're still... don't worry, that means you're still sane.
Okay, good. I was worried for a minute, because I was watching Day 9 play Amnesia Dark Descent, and whenever something scary happens, he's like, oh, fuck balls. Shitting dick nipples.
Oh yeah, by the way, oh yeah, by the way, all of you have probably rejoined us by now, so hello again!
This is the room right by the way, boss room, and this is like the hardest room in the level.
I'm not gonna make us
take a shot!
No, I'm not gonna make us take a shot right here, because you wanna know what, this is just refreshing, and at this point, I'm gonna kinda scare for you. By the way,
I'm fine.
Once again, feeling the pressure to get away from that fairy. I was like, oh my god, I gotta get away from that fairy before it hits me, and then I break my promise. Even if it's unwitting, at this point, I really feel like I shouldn't be getting it. Oh, come on! Yes!
Oh, you're a boss.
But yeah, that room there, if you did not notice the switch, you would have been like, how
okay,
the hell
two
am
and
I
three quarters of a heart against Morphophilia.
Dude, you're wrong.
No, I'm not. I'm kind of drunk. I'm not going to lie.
Okay. Well, we have had
Harvey, look out. This isn't normal water over there.
Yeah. That water is actually kind of cool looking. I wish more water would look like that.
Like blue? Okay, so this
but
is
like
the Jaws
actual blue instead of like
yeah.
You know, clear.
Okay, sure.
Like most water is clear with a little bit of a ripple. This water is actually blue.
Okay.
Or at least maybe actually the bottom of the room is blue and then like the top layer of I don't know. I don't do programming or graphic design for video games or anything, so
I'm so sleepy right now.
This is the best LP.
It is.
Okay.
Okay, so we're about to fight Morphophilia.
Morphophilia, yes. All right, now Morpha, it's this gigantic aquatic amoeba Morpha. See, I actually got it down this time. I didn't do it last time, but I did. I got the entire name. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so Morpha really only has one attack.
I saw a video of this guy who just hookshotted her and then put her in the corner and wouldn't let her get back to the water. It was quite easy.
Unfortunately, I'm not that pro.
Of course not.
Shut up. Okay, no. So Morpha basically only has one attack. That little tendril there... She will send out one tendril. At this point, I was having none of her shit, so I defeated her really easily, so I'm just gonna go with the entire thing. It's really easy. You target her, it. I'm sorry, taking Latin right now. Everything with an A has to be feminine.
I've seen enough hentai to know where this is going.
Although, actually, there is the third declension neuter, which the plural... the plural nominative is A. Okay. So, anyway.
I arum isosis. That's how I memorize the conjugations of Latin words.
Dude, that was...
No, wait, not conjugation. Sorry, declensions.
Sorry. Okay, anyway, but yeah. So, Morpha basically will...
You think Morpha
these...
knows Latin?
Shh, I'm talking
I'm
about...
I'm sorry.
Strategy. Dude, the fight's almost over.
Okay.
Morpha makes these tendrils. Morpha will come out in one of the tendrils. However, eventually, once you start getting damage on her, she's already dead, she will start to make more of them. So basically, get away from all the tendrils until you know she's in one of them, and then hook shot, long shot, whatever.
Can we take a shot to celebrate victory?
Actually, the water level is changing.
Okay, take a shot.
Technically. God, why are we... I sure hope... You know what? YouTube's probably going to, like, censor our video.
I'm going to eat the glass now because I'm hungry.
Not yet. There's one more shot to be had.
Okay.
One... Okay, even I'm starting to feel lightheaded.
Lightheaded. Everyone has small dicks, so it's okay.
How is that related? Oh, wait, that's right. The
heads,
entire story.
Heads.
All right. I'm
heart
not going to explain
piece.
It.
Da,
basically.
Da, da, da.
No, heart container.
Oh,
oh wait,
sorry.
I'm not putting this alcohol on your side of the table. No, yeah. Fuck. By the way, okay. You guys, I'm going to have a video, not a video, a picture up of our ghetto ass mic stand.
Okay.
Our mic stand is so ghetto.
It's literally a box with a hole in it, like a FedEx box. It's quite funny.
I got a product from Vat19, vat19.com, purveyors of curiously awesome products.
I have to pee with the intensity of a trillion suns.
I really hope that if I say vat19.com enough, they'll actually give me money.
Okay. Sponsorship.
Anyway, wait. This is the plot. This is where we're not supposed to talk.
Okay.
So shh. Well, we can talk, but nobody's going to be able to hear us. Oh god, I'm
just become an android.
Dude, look, that thing is like freaking out.
Take a shot.
Wait, take a shot. Okay, actually, we are live again. And that is the final shot.
I'm gonna eat the cup, okay?
I'm gonna eat it too.
Wow, it's fucking hard as shit.
I know, it's like a gummy bear, but it's super duper thick.
It's like the thickest dense cup I've ever eaten.
Stop putting thick things in your mouth, okay? Everybody's dick is small, though. that's the fourth time we've done it. That's way too many. Like, third time when I said it, like, deviating from when you said it was okay, that was like, oh my god, he said it, even though he said two shots that one time. Ooh.
Hey, can I, like, sleep in your room? I'm really tired.
You know, you did that last time that you were drunk.
I wasn't drunk before.
No, you were drunk before. You know the night with Katie?
Don't talk about her.
I'm not going to talk about her. Don't worry. For all of you who are watching the video, you don't need to worry about Katie. Just know this.
That's crazy. That's loud.
Shh, shh, shh. Nobody can understand you. That's the way it is right now. Oh my god. Oh my god. This is delicious. I'm gonna get some like ginger ale and put ginger ale shots in these for club tonight.
Okay.
That's a good idea. I'm gonna find my two best friends to do it with, though.
It's still chewing my food.
Okay. So there's Sheik. And Sheik's all like, congratulations, Harvey. And that was actually one of the most poignant parts in the game for me. Like, I was like, dude, she cares. Why does she care so much? What's this? What is up with this dude? Don't fucking spoil anything.
I'm not spoiling anything. Sheik is totally not Zeratul.
Dude, the fate of the universe hangs in the balance. Link, Harvey, whatever.
I will rule this sector or see it burn to the ground.
Okay. So basically, yeah, I decided to end this video with getting the water arrows.
Fire arrows. You suck.
Sorry, I saw a lot of water, and then I was like, you know what? Water arrows. Stop burping.
I'm not burping. You're a liar.
Okay, so... basically, you need to shoot the sun with your arrows when the...
Can I have another cup?
No, when it's just...
Okay.
Dude, this cost me $22 to get here. Okay. I spent money... I did the thing. Okay, anyway. Don't you fucking dare.
I was just gonna take a cup.
But you need to shoot the sun when it's just coming up, so... I play the sun song a couple of times, the sun's coming up, and then all of a sudden, like, a miracle from Jesus, or Muhammad, or Buddha, or Shiva, or whoever you happen to worship, there are arrows with, like, this polygon around it.
Made of fire.
This red polygon. Yes. Oh my god, these are delicious. I forgot how good
Give
these are.
Give me a fucking one of them.
No,
okay?
You're not allowed.
Why not?
Because you're drunk.
I'm not.
You are.
Give me.
You're totally drunk.
Okay.
Okay.
Fire arrows. Set it to sea yellow, and your arrows will be powered up!
Yes.
Exclamation mark! If you crotch hit something, I don't remember.
Crotch?
It said crouch or crotch or something.
You said crotch.
There was a CR word
anyway,
there.
Shut up. So anyway, what have we done today?
We went into a temple.
We got an even longer stretching springing object. And also, we defeated a whole bunch of skeletons. God, we defeated a whole...
We also
defeated Freud's id.
We got gold skull to us, bitches.
So we defeated Freud's,
How many gold skull to us does it take to conquer the Mongol horde?
It's the neuter pronoun. It's the neuter, like, pronoun, nominative singular for what the fuck, again?
Yeah.
I can't remember what it is.
What in the hell in the fuck? Yeah.
Anyway, watch day 9. Anyway, that is all for today. We are thoroughly tipsy to drunk.
How do I shot web?
Goodbye.
I'm not Lightspectra because I'm not tipsy enough to remember my name. Can I have a cup? It's made out of gummy worms. Give me a cup.
No!
Give me a cup.
Fuck you.
Okay.
We're done.
Okay. Save. If you fucking delete that file, I will kill you.
Oh god, it's saved! Oh god, oh no! Okay, this other one better not fucking mess up. Stop.